I'm going to show you how to live stream easily, fast, and you're going to look professional while doing it. And we're starting right now. Okay, so the very first thing that you want to do is you want to go to streamyard.com. Once you're on streamyard.com, then you want to put in your email address and click get started. As soon as you do that, Streamyard is going to send you a login code. It's going to look something like this. You want to click into that email, and then you want to copy the login code that they give you, and then paste it into the page on Streamyard where they're asking for your 6-digit code. From there, you click login. Now, when you log in, up in the top right-hand corner, you're going to see your account and your account preferences. Over here on the left is where you're going to do most of your activity here on Streamyard. So you're going to see broadcasts and you're going to see destinations. Here in the middle, you're going to see the option to create a broadcast, and you're going to see past broadcasts as well. And a really cool thing about Streamyard is, let's say that you want to repurpose some of your content for social media, or you want to take out little clips of your live streams and make them into video content for YouTube. Well, this gives you the ability to do that in a really easy way. So that's a bonus on top of being extremely easy to use for live streaming. But in order for all this to work, the very first thing that you gotta do is we are going to go up into our destination. You can see that I already streamed to a handful of places here, but you wanna click on add a destination up there at the very top. Once you do that, you're gonna see that you can stream to Facebook, you can stream to LinkedIn, YouTube, Periscope, Twitch. You can even stream to a custom RMTP if you would like. Now, if you don't know what that is, don't worry about it. It's not important at this point in time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up a Facebook destination for you and a YouTube destination for you so you can see how easy both of them are. If you just want to see YouTube, you can skip to that. I'll put a timestamp to it right here on the video. But the first thing that we're going to do is we're just going to click on Facebook group, and then we want to click connect Facebook. From there, you choose the group that you're going to stream into. For me, it's my Niminati VIP members only Facebook group. And then right here, we get the confirmation it was connected. Super easy. Now we're going to go back to destinations. I'm going to click add a destination again. This time we're going to do YouTube. So I'm going to click on YouTube channel. Now I'm going to go down to connect a channel. I'm just going to pick on this one down here. And then this box is going to pop up asking for permissions. This is okay. Basically, the reason they need this permission is so that they have access in order to be able to push your stream through your YouTube channel. So that's what this box is for. But all you have to do here is click allow. And then you get the confirmation here that the YouTube channel was connected. Super easy so far, right? Now that we have those connected, the next thing we're going to do is we're actually going to create a broadcast. I'm going to show you how easy that is as well. So we're going to click on create a broadcast, and then we're going to pick where it is that we're going to stream to. So in this situation, if I wanted to, I'm going to go ahead and just click on the Nimmin Live channel or the Nimmin Extra channel. But if I wanted to, I could also go ahead and click on the Niminati VIP as well. And then when I go live, I'll stream to both destinations. So I can have one live stream and I could have it streaming out to both destinations, which is really awesome if you choose to use that feature. But for now, I'm just going to focus it on YouTube. So of course, just like anything else that you do on YouTube, we're going to go ahead and add a title and description to this. And then just like when you upload video content, or if you live stream normally on YouTube, you have the option here to where you can select public, private, or an unlisted stream. So if you just want to stream with some buddies, you can do that here as well, just by making it unlisted. Or if you just want to test some things, see what your camera looks like, see what your audio sounds like on a replay, then in that situation, you can go ahead and just stream privately, which makes it really easy to test things and make sure that your streams are the way that you want them to be. But for this, I'm going to go ahead and just click unlisted so that I don't have anybody come into the stream while I'm showing you this. And then if I wanted to, I could just go ahead and click on create a broadcast and the whole thing would go ahead and get started. But what we're going to do instead is I'm going to click on schedule for later so that we can add some things to this here within Streamyard. So when we click on schedule for later, it gives me the option to upload a thumbnail. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And with this, you can select any thumbnail that you have on your computer. It's really easy. You just navigate to it, and then you click on open, and then it loads it. And then if you're just adding a picture, for example, one of the things that you can do is you can actually reposition and resize the image within Streamyard as well, so you can make sure you get a nice solid looking thumbnail. But in this situation, this is a thumbnail I use a lot. I know it's okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and click on apply. And then one thing that I recommend that you do, and I recommend that you do this with every stream that you use for Streamyard, is that you do make sure that you schedule it later so that you can just go ahead and get a general idea of when it is that you're going to be streaming, and you don't have to rush and be like, oops, I have to go in and start streaming. And so it gives you a little bit of a cushion when you're setting all this stuff up. But in my situation, I'm going to go ahead and set the stream for, let's say, 8:35, because right now it's 8:22. And then I'm going to click on create a broadcast. Now you get confirmation here of your broadcast. Now, one of the things to keep in mind here is, let's say that you have a regular stream that you do. You know, you say you do it every weekend like I do, or let's say that you live stream every day and you have certain events and you just want to make everything easy for yourself. One of the things that you can do, which I do from time to time, but not all the time, is that you can go ahead and just schedule all of this stuff here. And when you're scheduling it all here for each live stream that you do, you just enter your broadcast studio and then you're ready to go at that point in time. But for this example, we're just going to go with the one, and we are going to enter the broadcast studio here. So once you enter the broadcast studio, you have to put a name in here. So in your situation, you can put a channel name, you can put your name, whatever it is that you want. However, you can turn this off once we get into the broadcast studio here in just a second. I'm going to show you how to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and have the name here. But one thing that I do want to bring to your attention as well is, if we click on the settings icon here for the camera and the mic, you do have the option here to select whatever webcam it is that you want. If you click on advanced, you also have the option here to check your streaming resolution as well. Of course, I always stream 1080p. So because of that, I'm making sure that the high definition version of this is selected. Now, you can also select your audio device here. And one really cool thing here is, I don't know if you've ever had a live stream to where you started streaming and the microphone has been off. Well, while you're in here testing this, you can actually see the meters moving to make sure that your microphone is actually working before you go live, so that you don't have to worry about, you know, running into that situation. Now, the next thing that you're going to see here is the echo cancellation. Basically, what this does is, in a nutshell, it just makes your audio sound better. If you have a professional microphone or a professional audio setup, it's not as important to use it. But even with my setup, which is pretty pro, I still use the echo cancellation just to be on the safe side. You also have the option to automatically adjust the microphone level as well. This one I turn off because I like to have full control within the hardware that I use. But if you don't have a bunch of hardware, I really recommend that you turn this on, and then it will basically adjust it based on your voice and if you happen to have guests come in and things like that. So if you don't have a pro setup, make sure that you have this turned on. But if you do, then you know you have a little bit more flexibility in this situation. Now, you're also going to see here that they have the green screen option. So if you happen to be a green screen user and you happen to have the hardware to support it, and you have all the permissions set, you can also use a green screen with Streamyard as well. But for now, we're just going to go into the camera section just so I can get a confirmation of what my stream actually looks like, or what my, you know, my camera looks like. And then we're just going to close this down. And again, you can see right here, before we even go into the studio, the microphone is working. You know, the mic's hot. I know it. But if I want to turn that off for whatever reason, I can also mute. So if I just say, hey, you know, right now I'm coming into this, but I want to give it a minute before I turn the mic on, then that is where you actually mute that. So let's go into the studio. So as soon as you go into the studio, you're going to see I have a background already in here because I use Streamyard for every live stream that I do. But you are going to see that you don't see the webcam. So the very first thing that you want to do in this situation is, you're going to see down in the bottom left-hand side your webcam image. So you want to hover over that, and you're going to see the option to add that to the stream. Now, this is another place where if you wanted to, you could mute the mic. And then there's a three-dot menu to where you can edit the name if you want. You can edit the audio avatar. You know, you can stop the mic and cam if you want. Just so you have those options, kind of like a last minute thing on the stage is what I call this area, in the event that you want to make those changes. But for now, we're going to go ahead and just click add to stream. And then here we are. So just to give you a rundown of this interface, one of the really cool things about Streamyard is that it will show your comments right here. So when you're live on this end of it, you can look at your YouTube comments. If you get super chats, those are going to show up here. If you're streaming to Facebook and to YouTube at the same time or multiple destinations, it collects all of those comments and puts them right here so that you can make sure that you're monitoring the chat accurately without having to jump from platform to platform to platform in order to make sure that you're paying attention to everybody. But if we go over here to the right-hand side, we're also going to see that there's a banner area. Now, the really cool thing with this banner area, and I'm just going to go ahead and turn it on here so you can see, and you can notice as I'm hovering over this, it changes to show. That's how easy this is to use. All I have to do is just click on that, and you're going to see right down here at the bottom, it starts showing me a ticker of whatever it is that I put in this field. I can turn that on or off at any time that I want, and I can create different ones. So if there's different things that I want to express across my live stream or at different points in the live stream, I can just come into here and I can click these while I'm streaming, and then it will go ahead and put that information on the screen. So I'm just going to add one here just to show you what it is. And then, of course, you can say if you actually want it to just show up or if you want it to scroll across the bottom. I'm going to choose scroll. And then I'm going to hover that over here. I'm going to turn it on, and you can see right here how it's scrolling across the bottom of the screen now. The next thing that we have is the brand area. Now, when it comes to the brand area, and really quick, I just want to let you know that if you don't want to mess with any of this stuff that I'm showing you, because these are more, these features that I'm showing you are things that will actually help your stream look more pro and help it, you know, just have a little bit more of a dynamic feel to it instead of it just being a static image. But if you wanted to, you could skip all of this and you could just go straight to the go live. But I want to show you all of this because it can help you make your streams look better. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to go into brand. Now, inside of brand, you can see here that there's different options that you can use. I have a templates demo here. I have the just a testing thing where I go in there and I mess with stuff. There's the Streamyard branding as well for when I do the streams on the Streamyard channel. And one of the cool things here, and I'll just show you my Nimmin Live as an example, is that you can add graphics to this. Now, when you do that, you want to make sure that you're using transparent.png graphics. And the reason for that is so that you can have overlays with your cam behind them and you don't have to worry about it, you know, completely filling up the screen like you would with just like a photograph, for example. Now, you can also use GIF images. If you use a GIF image, you can do this as well, but you also have to make sure with that that you are exporting it with transparency. But you can see, as an example, I just click on this and then it shows the graphic right here on the screen for when I do my live stream. I use this to let people know that my stream is sponsored by StreamYard and TubeBuddy as well. I do this to bring some attention to my podcast, to where I let people know, hey, this is my podcast. You can go check that out. I also make sure that I add my social media information on the stream from time to time. And I also just have a little frame that I made. And that little frame, you can see that it's animated because this particular one is a GIF so that I can use that animation, but it's just something to, you know, grab attention down there in the bottom corner for anybody that happens to be coming into the stream so that I can show them, hey, you know, I do this every single Saturday at 9 a.m. Eastern. Now, if we keep going down, another thing that you're going to see, actually, let me go up a tad here, is you are going to see up here at the top next to logo, you're going to see where it says Nimmin Live. That's this option right up here on the screen that you see. Now, if I click on this, then it's going to change it to powered by StreamYard. And then I click it here and then it goes back to Nimmin Live. You can change that to whatever your logo is. You know, you can have your channel icon there, whatever it is that you want as a way to kind of brand the image that people are seeing during the entire live stream, which is pretty cool. Another thing that you're going to see here is remember how I put the name at the bottom of the screen as we were first coming in and I said you can take that off? Well, you'll see on the screen right now, that's not there. And the reason that that's not there is because if I scroll to the bottom, and I know I'm kind of jumping all over the place here, but I just need to in order to make this reference. But if you go down here to the bottom, you're going to see where it says show display names. If I click on this, then that name is going to come up right here on the screen. And the reason that I'm turning this on right now is because if I go up to the very top again, then they also give you theme options to where you can even change what this looks like. So I'm going to click on this and you can see how it changes it. Click on the minimal. You'll see how it changes it. The bubble, it changes it and adds some animation. Same exact thing with the block as well. So these two here are more animated. That one is as well. This one is more of just kind of like a pop into place type of thing. But let's say that your brand colors are blue. Well, in that case, then you would let me copy this so I don't lose it. But let's say that your brand colors are blue. You can click on the brand color up here and you can change it to blue. And then you'll see how it changes it all the way across all of these graphics so that it can match your brand color as well. Since mine isn't blue, I'm going to go ahead and change it back to mine. And then you can see how easy it is to swap those around. Now, like I was showing you before as well, since we're up here in the top, I'm going to show you this. If I wanted to create a new brand, let's say you have multiple YouTube channels, or let's say you have a different show that you do on Facebook than you do on LinkedIn or that you do on YouTube. Let's say everything's different. Well, in that case, you can just add as many of these brands as you want to, and then you can just switch to each one. And all of these things that I'm showing you right now are all going to be saved and contained. So all you have to do is just show up, add your stream like we showed you before, and then you can come in here and without having to add this every single time and all of that, it's all in here waiting for you. And all you have to do is just click on the different elements to bring them on screen. So for now, I'm going to turn the name off as we continue through the rest of them. Okay, so now as we keep scrolling down the screen, one of the things that you're going to see here is you're going to see video clips. Now, the cool thing about the video clips is if I click on this, you are going to see here that there's a 30-second countdown. You can add any video clip that you want to hear. You can use this for things like intros. You can use this for things like segues between different parts of your show. You can use this for end screens that show up on your video so that at the end of your live stream, you have a thing showing up, sending people to your marketing material, sending people to other videos on YouTube to where you have that graphic display. Things like that so that you can, you know, make your streams a little bit more professional and a little bit more polished. And then if we keep going down the page here, you're going to see we also have this background area. Now with the background area, if I remove my image here, you're going to see that we have this background. Now in my particular case, because I am coming in here just by myself, so you're not going to see the full, you know what? Let me set everything up for you. Okay, so what I did is you're gonna see right down here in the bottom left, I went ahead and just added myself to the stream as well, because with Streamyard, it's really easy to bring in guests. But right here, I'm going to add myself to the stream, and then I'm going to add this version of myself to the stream, which is on here on a laptop default webcam. So pardon the image there. But one of the cool things with these backgrounds is, let's say that you're on here with a guest, then I can click on this, and then you can have all kinds of graphics going on in the background. So I can switch on the backgrounds over here on the right, now that I know that I have a guest on here and it's not just me by myself. And you can see that I have these graphics on here to let people know that I have, you know, links down in the description. I've got some branding on here up at the top. And then of course, if that's on there, then I try to remember to turn that logo off up here at the top as well. But you can see that now that we have two different, you know, people on here or two different images on here, then now these backgrounds start becoming really valuable because you can use them to spread awareness about things if you would like to, let people know more about your show. You can also just go ahead and have, you know, a nice stack of these in here to where you're also trying to encourage engagement as well with what it is that you're doing through the backgrounds. And this background will show up even if you have three people on here, if you have 10 people on here, depending on the different things that you focus on. Sometimes it can get a little bit weird, like in this situation right here, you see that I have that background, and then when I switch the sizing, then everything looks a little bit odd. So because of that, that's why I always have a pattern background, which StreamYard actually gives you by default as well, which you can see in the background right here. But I always use the pattern background for a lot of the stuff so that I can make sure that it looks good when I have guests on here as well. Or if I do any of the weird sizing, I'll switch it before I make that change. So as an example, just to show you how that would work, is I would actually go full screen just by clicking on the icon right up here on the very top left down here in the layout. I would click on full screen, and then I would come here if I was gonna go to the wide guest, and I would click on one of these, and then I would click on this icon so that it matches that graphic. And then if I do it again for that weird sizing, I would do the same exact thing. I would make this large while I was talking, and then I would change it to the pattern background, and then I would take it off of full screen again, and I would change it to that. So you can see kind of the workflow of how all of that goes together. Now, another thing that I want to bring to your attention here is that, let's say that you do want to bring a guest onto your live stream. Let's say it's something that you do. Then in that situation, one of the really awesome things about StreamYard is they make it so easy. So in a lot of the live streaming software that you're going to use, you're going to have to do all kinds of crazy things in order to get somebody onto your live stream. In StreamYard, all you have to do is click on the invite option, and it's gonna pop up this window right here, and it's going to give you a code, and you copy that, and then you can email it. You can send it to somebody on Messenger. You can text it to somebody if you want, because you can access StreamYard on your phone as well. But it makes it really easy to bring guests into your live stream. And another thing, if you happen to make any type of tutorial content, if you're a gamer, anything like that, another really cool thing about StreamYard is they also enable you to easily share your screen. So if I click on the share the screen option, it's gonna give me the option to let me know, you know, which screen that I wanna share so that I can choose. And when I click here, it's going to open up both of them, my widescreen and my additional monitor. So in this situation, I just click on to share screen, and then I click on share, and then it brings it right down into here and it puts it on the screen. So from this point, I can say, okay, you know, these are the different things that I'm talking about and all of that, and you can see it on the screen. And if I want to, I can also click on that full screen option, take it full screen, and then the people that are participating in the live stream will still be able to hear me and they'll still be able to see what's on my screen. And anytime I want to take that back down, then I can do that, or I can completely remove it. And you can see the StreamYard kind of animates the entire process in terms of making all those transitions look kind of cool and animated as you're making all of those different changes. Now, the next thing that you want to do is, of course, you want to go live. Now, if you are streaming directly to YouTube, one of the things that you are going to need to do before you live stream is you're going to need to go into the stream itself, to the scheduled stream. This is another advantage of actually scheduling the stream. And you want to make sure that you mark that stream for kids or not for kids, as required by YouTube policy. You can also set up additional things, which I recommend when it comes to streaming directly to YouTube. I'll put a link to that at the top of the screen right now. But when it comes to Streamyard, there's another really cool feature in here, and it's called private chat. So what the private chat does is, if you look over here on the right-hand side, it allows you to actually have conversations with your guests only that the people watching the stream are not going to see. They're not going to be a part of. This keeps the chat clean, allows you and your guests to be able to communicate back and forth in a really easy way. So now, if you're ready to try this process yourself, you can head over to streamyard.com. Now, when it comes to live streaming, there's a lot of things that content creators do to kind of really mess things up for themselves, especially when it comes to YouTube. And I want you to avoid those things. So I'm going to put a video right here that you can watch right now that's going to cover those things for you so that you can have an awesome live stream and so that you can make sure that you're doing things the right way. Go ahead and click into that now. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.